If you're not getting along with the father of your baby, don't expose them to that. That can't be reversed. I once overheard my cousin's ex-boyfriend say that I wasn't gonna end up doing anything with my life. Babies and young children have been sexually assaulted. A lot of the times, it's with family. Our parents didn't even know that we were living on no money. Hi, darling. So this is the second video in a row that I am filming, so I will be wearing the same shirt in two different videos. For all the teen moms out there, consider me your big sister in this crazy adventure that you are embarking on. I've been through it during a time before social media and various resources and advice videos like this even existed. So I'm gonna share a lot of what I learned and the best pieces of advice that I can give you through what can sometimes seem like a very challenging but yet magical time in your life. So we're just gonna jump right in. Number one, don't miss out on your teen milestones. Balance is always key to staying sane and less resentful. I went to both my junior and senior prom, and I even ran for prom queen because I didn't let my own insecurities about what other people thought of me stop me from enjoying these milestones that I still had every right to partake in. Your baby deserves their mom to always be at their best, so remember, make time to relax and do something fun on your own. To be a good parent, you have to take a break from time to time. Find a babysitter, ask a family member or friend, or trade babysitting with another mom. Take a walk, read a book, see a movie, go out to dinner with a friend, or take a long hot bath. Number two, don't take advantage of people who offer to help but accept help when you need it. If you need help from somebody so that you can continue your education or work, when somebody says they are willing to help out by watching your baby, kindly accept that offer, but also don't take advantage of that offer. And don't use those people to pawn off your child so that you can have fun and hang out with your friends or go out doing non-productive things. If you do, you will run out of resources in the future, and instead of people helping, people may disconnect from you. People want to help you when they see that you're getting your life on track for your baby, not for the reason of encouraging negative behavior. Also, stay away from drinking and drugs. Your baby deserves a nice, clean mama. Number three, this is super important. You are not worth any less just because you're a teen mom. If you're not getting along with the father of your baby and you know in your heart that it's just not meant to be, understand that it's okay, but have a friendship with him. You might get the feeling that no guy will ever want to be with you, or some people at school might make you feel as if you're some used up girl, and it's so not true. And those people who are talking crap, they are deflecting their own insecurities on you. You don't need to find Mr. Right right away, but someday you will. Just remember, never settle for less than what you and your baby deserve. I'm glad that my mother met my stepdad because he was an amazing man, and if I had grown up with my biological father, it would not have been good for anybody. Number four, make a healthy environment. The first 5 years, your baby's brain is like a sponge, and those years shapes the kind of person that they will become. So your child should witness no violence, no fighting, arguing, and you should motivate yourself to promote learning and intelligence by reading every single day to your child. Read parenting articles on any questions you have on your child's mental development. Side note, if you think that it's okay to argue because you're in a different room, or maybe you think your child is too young and they might not remember you're fighting. Babies and children's minds are more in tune with reality than you think they are, and they always feed off the energy of what's happening around them. So please think about your child's psychological well-being. Don't expose them to that, because that can't be reversed. Number five, prove everyone wrong. I once overheard my cousin's ex-boyfriend say that I wasn't gonna end up doing anything with my life after I had my baby, and that I was just gonna end up on welfare forever. And I don't wanna hear that, but I'm so glad that I did, because that jerk gave me something to measure up to and made my drive and motivation stronger to prove people like him wrong. And I became way more than what people expected of me. So now that you're a mom, albeit a teenage mom, your mental state and responsibility level should be raised up to that of a 30-year-old. Find a job that pays well, and one of the most important things, a job that has great health insurance. Look up online places that offer great health insurance. I know off the top of my head that Whole Foods offers health insurance within like the first 6 weeks or something of working there, and you get major discounts on all the healthy food. You can do it, I promise. You can transform yourself into the woman that you want everyone to know that you are, and the person that makes your baby so proud. Number six, protect your child. This is going to get a little dark, but I don't care because it needs to be said. At a young age of being a teenager, we don't have a lot of experience in life to know that a lot of the times there are many situations where babies and young children have been violated violated or disgustingly sexually assaulted by their babysitters or the people who were trusted to watch or be around the child. A lot of the times, it's with family or even at a daycare. So at best, I would only recommend having your baby being watched by your mother or sister and know who's going to be around your child at all times. Be very paranoid when it comes to who's watching your child. I would even go as far to say if you need to get a hidden camera, do it. Last advice, it's going to be okay. When I felt so lost and out of touch with life in that point in my childhood, having a baby, not having much money, but wanting a car and to move out of my parents and not wanting to be on welfare, I never thought that we would be at this place in our lives that we are right now. Yes, Chris and I did have some help from our parents in the first year or two of having Lexany, but we didn't take help after that. We made a conscious choice to make sure that our daughter saw her parents just as capable, independent, motivated, making things happen for us and our family, just like any other parents who were financially stable grown adults. And we built this wonderful lives for ourselves, and it took struggle, but we wiggled out of many financial and emotional stresses and have been through periods where our parents didn't even know that we were living on basically no money and not asking for help, but that forced us to work harder to find ways, and we are the proud parents we are today because of it, and we built a lot of character from it. If we are doing fine, you will be just fine also. All right, my darlings, these are all of the things that I learned within the first few months and years of me being a teen mom. If you guys haven't checked out my daughter reveal plus Q&A video, make sure that you check that out. I'll link it down here and down below. Also, if you haven't seen my 15 and pregnant story time, where I talk about how I found out I was pregnant, what my parents did when they found out, and all of that, I'll also link that in the video down below. If you know anybody who was a teen mom, or if you're a teen mom, comment down below. I would love to hear from you and anything crazy that you would like to share during that teen pregnancy. Alrighty, my darlings, if you guys haven't already, go ahead and join our DMR Darling family by hitting the red button down below, and don't forget to hit the notification button as well so that you can be the first to be notified of all these crazy videos that I do on my channel. And don't forget to follow me on social media as well. I have all of my links listed down below. As always, I love you darlings very much, and I'll talk to you later. Bye, darlings. Mwah.